I met W.E.B. DuBois in his home. I think it was in Queens, but I'm not sure. I don't remember where I was or how I got there. It's amazing how when you're young, you don't really, you only grasp the things that are solidly important to you. I don't know how I got there. I don't know where I was. But his wife, Shirley Graham, had decided to help me raise the funds to go to study in Mexico. And so I was in their home. And it must have been a two upstairs, downstairs house, because as my picture of remembrance of him is that he came out and stood on something like a platform above us, and there were stairs that came down, and he was talking to me from up there. And this lovely warm voice, yes, up there. that is my memory of him. You know, that's all of it. But the important thing is that they were my supporters. They were my sponsors. They helped me to go to study in Mexico. And I'm sure that he really felt that I deserved it, because he had seen me many times performing. And everybody knew who I was in the progressive movement in New York, because I was out there, you know, doing all of the things that I was doing, and concerts with Paul Robeson. He actually went with me to Connecticut, and we gave a concert, and he sang a duet with me, and By and By was the name of it. I'm going to lay down this heavy load. And in Europe, the writer, the black writer who went to live in Paris.
Baldwin.
James Baldwin came with his play. And I believe that was Switzerland. And I visited with him. And when I say visited, we chatted together at the theater. I believe that's where we were. And had a very pleasant experience. He was so brilliant. Ooh, what a brain. And you really felt like you were with a great person when he talked, with greatness, as I felt with Paul, as I felt with W.B. DuBois.